Hi everyone, myself Lohit Dalal, lecturer, Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, Jain Polytechnic, Belagavi. Today I am going to discuss about error correction and detection. These are the contents I am going to discuss. First one, introduction. Second one, types of errors. Third one, error detection methods. Fourth one, redundancy, meaning of redundancy. And last one, in error correction, there will be different methods will be there. Those concepts you are going to studying in this unit. Okay, first one, introduction. So data can be corrupted during the transmission. Okay, for example, see here, in a digital communication system you are going to send the data from transmitter to receiver. Okay, so if you get the correct information, okay, then only the system is reliable. If you are getting the error, okay, so that the system will not be a reliable. Okay, in order to get the system to be a reliable, okay, reliable, in order to happen the reliable communication, or in order to do the reliable communication, we need to detect the errors and correct the errors. Okay, so next, there will be error correction and detection to be implemented for the data link layer and the transport layer of the OSI model. So next, there will be types of errors. There will be a single bit error and the bust error. Single bit error means there will be only one bit is going to change. Okay, here 0 is going to change into a 1. And a bust error means there are two or more bits are going to change. Okay, while sending the information from transmitter to receiver, there are two or more bits are going to change. Here 0 is changed to 1. Okay, so next, error detection. Okay, in error detection, it includes the concept of redundancy. Okay, it is going to, while transmitting the data units to the receiver side, okay, so you are going here, you are going to add a what, extra bits. Okay, extra redundant bits you are going to append it with the data units, so that if suppose error is detected, okay, so that these bits are, okay, so if suppose error is found at the receiver side, okay, that error should be detected with the help of a redundant bit instead of retransmitting the message once again or retransmitting the data message, data bits once again. Okay, so it uses the concept of the redundancy. Okay, redundancy means adding the extra bits to the data unit. Okay, so let us discuss what is redundancy or a meaning of redundancy. Okay, see here, instead of repeating the entire data stream, a shorter group of bits may be appended to the end of each unit. This technique is called as a redundancy. Okay, once, okay, extra bits are appended to the entire data unit or shorter group of bits, okay, shorter group of bits you are going to append it to the data units, okay, in order to recognize the errors, okay, in order to detect the errors. Okay, once the accuracy is achieved at the receiver side, data, okay, whatever the appended data will be there, okay, that bits are discarded. Redundancy. This is the block diagram of the redundancy. Okay, so redundancy means data you are going to generate, okay, after generating the data you are going to check the redundancy, it is redundant or redundant to the transmission or not. Okay, so if it is not, you are going to add the redundancy, redundant bits. Okay, depending on the number of ones even or odd. Okay, number of ones are even you are going to add 1. Okay, number of ones are odd, you are going to add it as a zeros. Okay, as a redundant bits. So then you are transmitting at the receiver side, depending on the number of ones and number of ones even or odd, depending on that it is going to accept. Okay, this concept is used. Okay, there are different methods to detect the errors. Okay, this is the concept of redundancy. So next, there will be a different types. Okay, there are usually four types of redundancy checks, redundancy check methods. First one, VRC, LRC, CRC. Okay, VRC means vertical redundancy check, longitudinal redundancy check. LRC, CRC means cyclic redundancy check. Okay, vertical redundancy check, it is also known as a parity check. Okay, it is the least expensive mechanism for the error detection. In this technique, the redundant bits called as a parity bit, it is appended to the every data unit, so that total number of ones in the data unit is becomes, total number of ones in the data unit becomes even. Okay, that includes the parity bit. Okay, see here, the concept of VRC. Suppose their data unit will be 110001 will be there. Okay, this data you are going to transmit. Okay, depending on the number of ones. Okay, suppose number of ones are odd, you are going to add a data as a 1. Okay, redundant bit as a 1 means here even parity generator will be there at the center side. So in a data unit you are going to check number of ones are even or odd. Okay, suppose number of ones are odd, you are going to add as a 1. Okay, so one has a redundant bits. Okay, so at the receiver side again it is a checking function. Is the total number of ones are even, then only if suppose yes, then data transmitted is correct. If it is not, it is yet data transmitted is wrong. Okay, so that it is going to detect the error. So there will be a redundancy check methods will be there depending on the number of ones are even or in even or odd in the data units. If suppose number of ones are odd, you are going to add as a redundant bit as a 1. Okay, so number of ones are even, you are going to add it as a 0. Number of ones are even, you are going to add it as a 0 as a redundant bit. Okay, there will be a advantages. Vertical redundancy check can detect all single bit errors. Okay, it can detect the burst errors if the total number of errors in each data unit is odd. Total number of errors in the each data unit is odd. Okay, so VRC cannot detect the errors where the total number of bits changed is even. Okay, even number of bits are changed, then it is unable to detect the errors. So next, longitudinal redundancy check. Okay, in this method the data bits are organized in terms of a rows and column in order to calculate the parity bit for each column. Okay, and also the set of parity bit is also sending with the original data. Okay, with the original data, set of parity bits are transmitted. Okay, this from this block you are going to understand this is the data bits you are going to transmit. Okay, so these are arranged in a columns. Okay, so number of first column number of ones are odd, so that you are going to add as a 1 as a redundant bit. Okay, second one number of ones are even, you are going to add a 0 as a redundant bit. Okay, so depending on the redundant bits you are going to detect the errors. Okay, these redundant bits are transmitted with the help of transmitted accord with the data units only. These are data units. Okay, so what you will get here, so see here, suppose you are going to send, the block is sent. Okay, so there will be LRC you are going to send. Okay, block length will be there, some kind of data you are going to send. These are the redundant bits. Okay, so if suppose these are the with the redundant bits you are going to send in order to detect the errors. Suppose there is a error received at the side. Okay, means if suppose see here there will be two or more bits are changed here. These two bits are changed. First column one, two bits are changed. So what will get here? One is changed to 0, one is changed to 0. Number of ones are odd only. So redundant bit will not change. So it is unable to detect the error. Okay, that is the drawback. So okay, two or more bits are changed means you will not get the error. Okay, you are unable to detect the error. That is the drawback of the LRC. Okay, so see here, what is the advantage? LRC, this longitudinal redundancy check method, it is applied for a n number of bits to detect the burst errors. Two or more bits are detected. Okay, it can be applied for large number of bits. Okay, what is the disadvantage? If two bits in one data unit is damaged, okay, so it is exactly in the same position, other data units are also damaged, the LRC checker will not detect the errors. It is unable to detect the errors. So see here, next, cyclic redundancy check. Okay, in this method the sequence of redundant bits is called as a CRC. So CRC it is using the remainder methods. Okay, so what you are doing here, just see here, the redundant bits you are going to, okay, so what you are going to do here, just so for a data with the data unit, data unit can be divided with the predefined binary number. Okay, predefined binary number. Okay, if suppose you will get the remainder, some value of the remainder you will get. Okay, that remainder you are going to add with the sender. Okay, add with what? Data. Okay, data bit. So you are going to send at the receiver side. Okay, the receiver side, what you are going to do, you are going to do the data bit. Okay, again you are going to divide it with the that predefined number. Okay, if both the reminders, okay, both the sides of the reminders are similar, so error it is found that error will not be received. Okay, if suppose both the reminders are not similar, okay, that there will be a error will be received. Okay, see here, there is a CRC generator and checker will be there. So from the sender side you are going to send the data. Okay, divisor will be there, there will be a some n plus 1 bits will be there.
okay, that bits are added with the data, okay, that reminder is added and you are going to send. Okay, so after that what you will do, that data CRC will be there, again you are going to divide the data, okay, so you will get the reminder, okay, so reminder is 0, and also you can use the concept, reminder 0 means both the sides reminders are 0, it is going to accept it, non-0 it is going to reject, okay. So this is the method, polynomial method, okay, the divisor is determined according to the algebraic polynomial. Polynomial, you know that x raised to 7 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 2 plus x plus 1, okay. So you are, from polynomial you are going to determine the data, okay. So how you are going to determine the data, depending on the coefficients of the x, okay, x raised to 7 will be there, so data unit is 1, x raised to 6 is not there, data is 0, x raised to 5 is there, so your data unit is 1, okay. Similarly, x raised to 4 is not there, you are going to data unit is a 0, x raised to 3 is not there, data unit is 0, x raised to 2 is there, so coefficient is 1, x raised to 1, data unit is 1, okay. So next there is a 1. So next, polynomial should be selected according to the following rule. It should not be divisible by the x, it should be divisible by x plus 1. See here, this, okay, so predefined number is divided with the data unit, okay, we'll get the some kind of reminder, okay, 0, 0, 1, it is not displayed in this slide, okay, 0, 0, 1 will get here, okay, 0, 1, 1 or something you will get, okay, there will be different types, different you will get, so next you will get here 0, 0, 0, okay, again here also you will get 0, 0, okay, so you will get 0, 0, 0, so that there will be a different, so you will get the error, okay, if suppose similar concept you will get, so that time you will not get the, so see here 1 1 you will get 0 0 0 you are getting, okay, see here, see this one will be here, so what you will get here 0 0 0 1 you are getting, okay, here 0 0 0 you are getting, so there will be a reminders are not similar means error is received, okay. So next concept, error correction. Error correcting code is includes the enough redundant information along with the each block of the data sent to enable the receiver to deduce what the data to be transmitted, okay. So what error correction means, whatever the data to be transmitted and whatever the data to be detected, okay, that is, if it is not correct you are going to correct the data, okay. There will be a error correction method can be handled, okay, there will be two methods will be there. First, okay, the when error is achieved, okay, error is discovered, okay, the receiver tells that to the sender to retransmit the message once again, okay, there will be an automatic repeat request, we can use that, okay. Next, receiver can use the error correcting codes which automatically correct the certain errors. There are two types of error correcting codes, single bit error correction and bust error correction, okay. So error correction can be done with the help of a humming code. Humming is a R.W. Humming is a scientist, okay, he is used a humming code to detect the errors. Humming code can be applied to the data units of any length, okay, you can apply it for any length, okay, the relationship between the data and redundancy bits, okay. For example, see here, so 7 bits of ASCII code requires 4 bits of redundancy, okay, each bits are added to the end of the each data unit, okay, with the original data bits. These bits are placed in the position of 1 in the power of 2, 1, 2, 4, 8, okay. We refer to as a bits as a R1, R2, R4 and R8. Okay, see here the positions of the bits are, first position will be there, second position will be there and fourth position, eighth position, redundancy bits are you are going to add. Okay, redundancy bits are also named as a parity bits. In the humming code, each R bit is a VRC, vertical redundancy check. Okay, there will be R1 is the one combination of the data bits, R2 is the another combination, so on. Okay, so there may be R4 and R8. Okay, the combination used to calculate the each of the four values of 7 bit of data sequences are, R1 is the 1 3 5 7 9 11th position, R2 is the 2 3 6 7 10 11th position, R4 is the 4th 5th 6th 7th position, 8th is the 8 is the 8 9 10 11th position, means there are parity bit positions, okay. So see here, so data unit will be there, 100 1101 will be there, so that first adding a redundancy, okay, means the 1 1 3 5 7 9 11 position will be there, redundant bits, okay. So mean one parity bit, one skip, okay, one parity, one skip, you are going to make the, okay, in this way you are going to add the redundancy, okay, R2 second position, 2 2 2
two parity bits, okay, to skip two parity bit, two skips you are going to make, okay. So in this way 2 3 6 7 10 11 positions will be there, okay. R4 means 4 bits you are going to skip, 4 bit parity you are going to add, okay. 8 bits you are to skip, 8 bit parity you are going to, 4 bit parity you are going to add, okay. 8 bits are skipped, okay. 4 bits are skipped, 4 parity, 2 skips, 2 bits of data, 2 parity, 2 bits of data will be there, okay. So for here sender and receiver, suppose 1 bit of data is received error, okay. See here, so these are the data units you are going to add, R1, R2, R4, R1, R2, R4, R8, okay. Suppose there will be a last at the last side, last, okay. So there you are getting error, okay. So how you are going to determine the redundancy here, depending on the number of ones are even or odd, okay. Number of ones are, check here, number of ones are odd here, first one, okay. Number of ones are odd, okay. So I have marked with arrow, okay, 11th and 11th, okay, 11th and 11th, 9th position, okay. See here, so this whatever displayed in the color, you read it just 1, okay. There will be a odd number of ones, odd number of ones means redundant bit will be 1, okay. So see, similarly for second one, there will be again odd number of ones, there will be 1. Third one also odd number of ones, there will be even number of ones as the redundant bits, so you will get a 0, okay. So there will be a 7 bit is, with the position of the 7 bit is an error, okay. If you compare with the transmitted data, you will get the error, okay. So 7th bit you will get the error 0111, okay. So this redundant bit is going to change, so you will get the error, okay. Thank you.